Over the years of independence, we have made 169 launches of Ukrainian-made carrier rockets or rockets with a large number of Ukrainian components. We have launched 385 satellites during this time by the orders from 25 countries of the world. This is quite a significant result.
On the day when the world marks the first flight into space, the Ukrainian state space agency is making plans for the future of national space industry. At present, Ukraine is a significant player in this sphere, says head of the agency's public counsel Eduard Kuznetsov. In addition to the image of the country, being a space power is beneficial as well.
Probably our leaders of the state don't know this, but every dollar invested in the development of space industry brings $14-15 in profit. Having about $1,800,000 of funding, we brought more than $35.5 million to the budget annually.
President Volodymyr Zelensky promised to pay special attention to the development of the space sector. He called the launch of a new Ukrainian satellite one of the main tasks for the current year. With its help, Ukraine is going to resume its presence in the Earth's orbit.
We should do everything, and each of us should make a significant contribution in order that Ukraine prove its status of a space exploring state.
Currently, Ukraine is a member of the Club of 13 Space States. Ukrainian scientists and spacecraft designers have contributed much to the development of the industry. All the words of Yuri Gagarin during the first flight, starting from the well-known "Let's go," were recorded by a tape recorder made in Kyiv. The direct radio communication was provided, including from Simferopol radio point number 10. And after the historic flight, more than 500 Ukrainian designers and engineers of rocket and space technologies, as well as 15 Ukrainian scientists, received the highest awards. One can know the role Ukraine played in the history of space conquest in Kyiv Planetarium or in the National Polytechnic Museum.
Gagarin's flight lasted 108 minutes. It was just necessary to provide communication with the cosmonaut. Here is the Zarya tape recorder, which was used on board to record Gagarin's talk with the Earth. It was made in Kyiv indeed.
And Leonid Kadenyuk became the first astronaut of the independent Ukraine. In 1997, he took part in one of the NASA programs. This capsule also went into space in 1984.
This is a real spacecraft that has been in flight. It was created under the technical guidance of Serhiy Korolev, who studied at Kyiv Polytechnic Institute. The apparatus of a kind was suggested by Korolev for Yuri Gagarin, the first man to fly into space.
Reported by Vadim Kramer and Danilo Kobza, UATV News.